Airfix, as we know it today, dates from around the mid-50s. The plastic construction kits became very popular during the 60s and, in 1970, Airfix produced its 7th edition catalogue. This was a huge catalogue of 48 pages, with around 400 models listed, ranging from a skeleton, yes, really, to large ocean liners. This film tells the story of that catalogue. Sit back and enjoy. Man finally reached the moon in July 1969, and many people in the UK stayed up very late to watch Neil Armstrong become the first person to step onto the moon's surface. Airfix were hot off the mark and soon produced a superb construction model of the moon lander which joined the Saturn V rocket in the 1970 catalogue. Since the 50s, aviation models have always been a key part of the Airfix lineup, with a model of a Spitfire being the first to be produced. A large range of aircraft kits was to be found in every catalogue. Aircraft of all types were covered, including First World War biplanes, Allied and Axis aircraft from the Second World War, and more recent military and civil aircraft. Take a peek at some of the aircraft and other construction kits that were in the 1970 catalogue. The Sunderland was built by Short Brothers of Belfast. It was a big, ungainly, ugly duckling flying boat, and many people will now be unaware that such an aircraft saw active service during the Second World War. Yet the part it played was of immense importance. The aircraft's 13 hours endurance capability allowed it to venture far out into the Atlantic, to rescue torpedoed sailors, and to search for and destroy German submarines with bombs or depth charges. As the war developed, the heavily armed Sunderlands were also used in other areas of war, and the crews of attacking enemy aircraft soon found out that this big, lumbering aircraft was not the easy target they expected. For youngsters, who were not yet ready to build model aircraft, Airfix had these playsets. The playsets included a zoo, a French Foreign Legion fort, Sherwood Castle, and a US cavalry fort, complete with hostile Red Indians. This cavalry fort was of course made from plastic, but, in real life, the fort would have been made of wood. Which raises an interesting question. In films and television programs, the cavalry forts were usually built on the prairie, miles from anywhere, and often, without a tree in sight. So, where did the wood come from to build the fort? The world needs to know. The Historic Figures Collection. This includes Oliver Cromwell, Charles I, and Henry VIII. In real life, these people may have looked quite fearsome, but they probably didn't look half as scary as these models. The catalogue featured a few special items, including this working model of an 1804 Richard Trevithick locomotive. In 1808, a locomotive of this design would haul the world's first passenger-carrying train on a circular track in London. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little look at the Airfix 1970 catalogue. I think I've covered most items. Oh, hang on. There's one thing I've missed. The Skeleton. Since 1970, the Airfix world has changed a lot. Many items featured in the catalogue, including the model railway 00 gauge trackside items and figures, and many of the sets of battle figures, are not now produced. A big loss is the deleted skeleton, which must have provided a lot of amusement and enjoyment in the past. However, many of the aircraft models featured in this 1970 catalogue are still made by Airfix. Unfortunately, when this film was produced, June 2020, the often overlooked short Sunderland, now appears to have been also overlooked by Airfix, as the model is not currently available. It is sad that memories of this important and unique aircraft are now rapidly fading into history. Perhaps the model will return in the future.